Hey guys, what's going on? This is Bad Fish, and welcome back to another episode of San Pedro. If you're new to my channel, San Pedro is my current ongoing City Skylines project based off of the American West Coast, so welcome to you. First of all, guys, sorry for the delay between videos. I've had a long week. There's been a lot going on in my life, so I just wanted to first apologize for not getting out on my typical schedule. I should be returning to that soon, but I did just want to get this one out to you. And today, guys, what we're gonna be doing is building out a nice little shopping center here in San Pedro proper. I've been wanting to do this for a little bit. We don't have a ton of commercial area in San Pedro, the main city itself. Most of our commercial stuff is kind of outside the purview of the main city. So I wanted to put this in. Also, if you watch my last, or not last episode, but the Marina episode, so two episodes ago, I really wanted to put in this AMC movie theater that you saw me plop down. I haven't had the chance to do that since like the very beginning of San Pedro's put in a movie theater. So I kind of wanted to have like a nice cool shopping area with, you know, like the movie theater and some restaurants and just give my Sims some things to do. So what you're seeing me do now is just plopping down a bunch of different assets for like the shopping areas and centers and things like that. So I got King Leno's shopping center pack, and then the Riverside shopping center pack, also by King Leno, plus just some other superfluous assets like that Best Buy and the movie theater. Obviously, I think the Best Buy was from when I made the mall, and the movie theater I used way back in the very beginning of San Pedro. So right here, this is that Riverside pack by King Leno I was talking about, just popping that in. I really like the look of it. I think it looks really nice. Just in this kind of motif, in a West Coast motif, I think kind of like the stucco-ish outside of it looks very nice. And then some of the older stuff, it has that like real nice brick look to it, which I like. So you're just seeing me clip buildings together, just trying to get things to fit in unique and unusual ways rather than just using the buildings as they are. So that's just kind of what I'm trying to do here. You're gonna see me do like right here, I do a lot of clipping with these buildings to get the Best Buy and the Barnes & Noble to connect. So I put in two buildings there. And then I'm gonna clip this Forever 31 and this Express together. And then I am going to put a restaurant over on the side on one of the areas that I was just working on. We'll go back there in a minute. So again, just clipping together stuff, putting in this AutoZone, and then here's that restaurant I was talking about. I tried to put in this little one, didn't look great, so then I grabbed this Black Angus one, and for some reason it fit with the motif of those buildings so well that I really liked how it looked clipped together. So we put that in there, and then just some fast food restaurants on the side. And now I'm gonna get into my detailing. So first off, just adding in some loading docks and stuff. So that was one thing in the last shopping center I made I didn't add, was a ton of like loading spaces. So I wanted to make sure I got that right on this go around. So really just wanted to make sure that we have places for trailers to come in and out of and load up these stores and make sure that they're staying, you know, well stocked and all that good stuff. So that's what I'm doing here, just putting those in, throwing some trucks on some of them. Some of them don't have trucks, and we'll get back to detailing the areas around those in a little bit. But first, we're just gonna start putting down some parking. So a lot of my detailing I cut out of this one, simply because it was a lot of repetition. So I did a lot of parking areas, did a lot of manicured landscaping, did a lot of loading docks and things like that. So I keep a good amount in just so you guys can get kind of an idea of the work that I did, but man, was it repetitive doing this shopping area at certain points. So I did cut some of that out, and you're gonna kind of see in the live play a lot more parking lots than you know, you might have noticed in this time lapse, and definitely a lot more trees than you're gonna notice in this time lapse. So this is kind of the trees motif that I wanted to go with, was doing these oval planters with some brush on the bottom, and then the two big palm trees that we've been using throughout San Pedro a ton, honestly. I think these are probably my most used tree in the entire place besides the gum trees, which I'm using for like the more natural growth. So we got a lot of those palm trees. And then in the middle here, I just wanted to have some green space in with the shopping center. We had a couple more of these kind of like little natural growth areas, but I liked it just to kind of compartmentalize the parking lots from the theater and, you know, the parking lots from the bulk of the shopping area. So that's what we're doing here. We're just gonna go ahead and put in the natural growth the same way we usually do in San Pedro. Pedro, so you're gonna see me putting down this brush and bushes and wildflowers and things on the bottom, and then like I said, those gum trees right on top. So I just made a chunk and then kind of spread them out, and then I deleted a whole bunch just so it didn't look so copy and pasted. And then now what we're gonna move on to doing is, once we kind of get the last little bits of brush put down there, we are gonna put some seating areas just kind of around the entire shopping center pretty much. So I really wanted it to be in front of the AMC to begin with. I feel like a lot of movie theaters I've gone to, at least, they always have places for people to kind of congregate, hang out right in front of the movie theater. Definitely where it's like a place that maybe, you know, teens go to and they have to wait for their parents to come pick them up. They need a place to sit and they don't want them to be inside the theater, that's for sure. So I did that kind of same motif around a couple of different places. Again, I did a ton of it, so I cut some of it out, but you will see some more of those seating areas kind of sparse throughout the time lapse and the live play. So now I'm just building in the first of our little loading areas here right on the back side of this little shopping area. So I'm fencing it in. Not all of them are gonna be fenced in. Some of them are. I left it up to the business owners, honestly. So we're just putting some trash down, some different recycling areas, different crates and stuff like that to just kind of get the sense that this is a place that they come in and out of, to, you know, bring different loading materials in and all that good stuff. And then now I'm working on one of those seating areas that I mentioned earlier. So this one just had a lot of blank concrete right in front of it, so I just want to put some planters down. I tried to do like a triangle kind of diagonal shape. Yeah, I messed it up. It didn't work. So I ended up just kind of doing this little L and just putting in, again, more of those palm trees. And we're going to just put some different underbrush for this one, so we kind of have these bigger fern kind of deal, and then the typical underbrush that I've been doing right around the side. And right here on this area, we're just going to put more of those planters down with the big palm trees. So again, just trying to keep the motif going throughout. I wanted everything to kind of link up together. So I am using different types of buildings. Like, if you've noticed, they're not all the same shopping center pack. So to tie them all together, I wanted to kind of have those trees going on through everything, just to keep that motif and keep it kind of delineated from the rest of like the residential part of San Pedro. And then, of course, just more parking lots. You saw me just kind of edge in that little teller drive up on this bank here. And then in a second here, we're going to go through on the bank and put in a little bit more detail. But first, just want to fill up this parking lot. We're going to add a couple planters with those trees again, just right in the middle, just to kind of break up the parking lot a little bit. And again, make it look more interesting when you scroll out. And then right here, we are just going to put a little walkway right up to this first Skylines bank. So I didn't do this for all the buildings, but just for a couple of them, I wanted to have some cool little walk-ups, and definitely for the bank, where, you know, it's a place that, you know, wants to look very professional, wants people to either deposit or, you know, withdraw money or take out loans. They want it to look nice when you walk up. So that's what I did there. Just put in a couple planters. Again, just move the parking over, just to add a little bit more. And did that kind of like brickwork to do the walkway. And then over here, just putting in another little loading area off to the side. Again, I just wanted this to look well used. I wanted it to look like they're trying to really keep these stores stocked up. So this one, just a little bit different. I put a couple more extra trailers on the side there. I am going to put in a little bit of these like pallets and things, just to show that, you know, maybe they're moving things from store to store, so they need to load up some of these trailers for a truck to come pick up, things like that. And then I didn't like how much area I had next to the trash, so I just put in some extra parking right there for the bank. Or maybe this is, you know, employee parking for the Bed Bath and Beyond, who knows. Then right in between our parking lots here, I did want to just have a little bit more than just painting that in with concrete. So I'm just using these fences as I delete my entire parking lot. Let's pop that back. So I'm just using these fences to break up the space a little bit. And then right in the middle, we're going to do another little natural growth area. So this is just a good way to mix in the greenery and with whatever you're doing. You know, if you just take out some of the concrete, put in some dirt and stuff, and then fence it in and pop in some trees, it's just an awesome way to break things up and to add greenery into any space within, you know, a major city and make it look believable. And then now what we're doing on the side of this Best Buy here, they have like a little mechanics bay. So I wanted to put down some like junker cars that maybe they're using for parts, and then did like a little maintenance bay mechanic area right here. So we're gonna have some workers working on these cars. We're gonna have some tools kind of sparsed out through it. And then again, we're just gonna break up the concrete because there was a bunch there by putting in another little natural growth space. And along the natural growth space, we'll also put some parking. So first we're just putting down again, the underbrush and then our trees and just deleting a few of them, kind of moving around. What I like to do when I do these is kind of float around it in a 360 and see it from every angle and delete things as I go. So I just kind of fill it up, move around, delete. So that way I can kind of get a better view of it from all different angles. And then again, just filling up that parking lot and finishing out this little area with a little more of a trash pickup. I wanted those in back of pretty much every big box store because box stores make a lot of trash. And then this is a fun little detail. So I've done this before, but I'm just edging in the drive-through for this In-N-Out Burger right here, or excuse me, Down-N-Out Burger right here. So we're just putting down some planters and then some lines to delineate where the drive-through lanes are and the arrows of which way you need to go through the drive-through lanes and just putting down some small trees and stuff. But that is just gonna about do it for the time lapse, guys. So we're gonna finish out as always just by putting down our decals and our lights, but I really hope you enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun building this one out. Again, I apologize it took so long to get out to you guys. Just a long week, but I really hope you did like it. And if you did, definitely leave a like down below and definitely subscribe if you are new here and you haven't already. But we're gonna jump into a live play for the rest of the video and then some cinematic shots. So I will let the music play out for this part and I will see you on the other side. Hey guys, welcome to the live play side of today's build. I hope you enjoyed that time lapse. If you did, definitely leave a like down below. That helps me out a ton. And if you haven't already, definitely subscribe. But let's jump into what we built here today. We'll start here right on the end. So a lot of my detailing today was a lot of parking as well as these, you know, kind of like shipping and receiving areas for these bigger box stores and some of these seating areas that you'll see kind of spread throughout. So this is just like a Forever 21 and Express. So some I guess, I don't know if they're higher end, honestly, but you know, some clothing stores right there. And we of course got these planters going around with the big palm trees all through it. And then over here, this is like our little Best Buy slash AutoZone. So just a bunch of different commercial stuff. Really what I wanted to do with this build is just add a ton of commercial area since we were kind of hurting for it. We don't have a ton of commercial space kind of throughout San Pedro. So I wanted to add some more in here. So we got all of this going on. So just kind of throwing down different commercial props. Some of them are kind of themed together, some of them aren't. So this I really like, this is our In-N-Out Burger. And then I kind of detailed up this little area for the drive-through. So I put in this line and just some planters and stuff. Like I said, a ton of parking, some like natural growth stuff over here. Then as we go on through to connect this Best Buy and this Barnes & Noble, I clipped in these two buildings here. So that's an Einstein Bagels and a Smoothie King. I just did that because the way these were connected, there was this huge blank space here and then these fit kind of perfectly in and you can't even tell on the backside, which I'm really happy about. So that's what's going on there. And then of course we have our Best Buy and little seating area in front of it. And then over here, this is like Best Buy mobile installation. I didn't really know what that was. I'm assuming it's probably like something like they install electronics and stuff, but I made it into a little mechanics yard. So we got like employee parking back here with some junked out cars that maybe they use for parts and little mechanic stop there. Whether or not that's what it's actually used for in real life, who knows? And then of course a little trash gathering area right here. And then the reason I really wanted to do this build is I wanted to use this AMC again. I wanted to put a big movie theater. I was gonna actually do it in the marina build, but I just ran out of space. So I wanted to just put it in here. So we got this cool little walk up. I feel like a ton of these kind of movie theaters always have like big seating areas out front people to hang out in as that truck just destroys my fountain. Thanks, bro. So yeah, I just wanted to have like a cool little walk into it and have, you know, places for people to sit and chill out. And it stretches on through here as well. And then this is one of those themed areas I was talking about. So this is like a Party City, a Little Caesar, Subway, GameStop, all that good stuff. This is a pack from King Leno. So this is one of his awesome shopping center packs. I know like the River Park Shopping Center, I believe, is what this stuff is. I forget what this one is, but it looks great. It's got this cool brickwork. My idea is like this one and this one with the brickwork going on and kind of these weathered tops are the older shopping center. And then they kind of expanded outward from those. So maybe it was just these two buildings at first and then they pushed this way and a little bit this way. Just my idea behind it and why I use the different buildings. It definitely wasn't because I ran out of, you know, assets. So then back here, just another little loading area, some more parking. Then through here, like I said, this is King Leno's River Park pack. And I apologize for any skipping. My FPS is starting to get hurting a little bit in San Pedro. We just got a lot going on, but you know, it is what it is. It doesn't look terrible. So then this is like the River Park pack. Like I said, I threw in this restaurant here. So this is the Black Angus restaurant, just kind of in this corner here, just to add some more interest to it. Again, these trucks are just destroying my stuff. But again, just to add a little more interest to it and not have it all be this. And again, not have that like blank space right there. So I slotted in this Black Angus. I think that looks nice. Then just a couple more little fast food places through here. Another little loading dock. It looks cool. Looks great. Over here, we got like our little Staples and Panera Bread. Same deal, parking in the middle. Again, this is our old growth stuff here. So this Bed Bath & Beyond, the Bad Hombres, and this little bank here. So this is the first Skyline Bank. I did put just a little walkthrough or walkway up to it just to make it look a little more fancy because it's a bank. So, you know, they want to make people think they're fancy and they'll give them money and stuff like that. So put this little walkway right up to that and kind of decorated in this little drive-through thing here for the teller. And then as we come through here, we're on the back side of that Bed Bath & Beyond. So again, just more of a loading area. I put a little bit more here, so some more trailers and some pallets and forklifts and stuff. And then of course we got our big parking lots. So these are actually dynamic parking lots. So any cars here are the actual Sims parking, which is great. And I think this will get pretty well used once we start building down this way a little bit more. And then finally, well, actually, we already went over this. So we already looked at the Express and the Forever 31. So that is everything. So that is our build here today, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. Again, like I said in the beginning, sorry it took me so long to get an episode out. It's been a crazy week for me. Just a lot going on here. But I appreciate your patience and I appreciate you guys watching this far in the video. If you liked it, definitely leave a thumbs up down below. That helps me out a ton. Check out my channel. I typically post a few times a week. We got a ton of different builds in there. Definitely subscribe if it's what you're into. And I also have a Twitter and a Instagram that I will post in a comment down below and also in the description. So if you want to check those out, I typically just post more scenes of San Pedro, more shots and more detail stuff. So if you want to check that out, definitely look at those. They'll be down below. But I hope you guys enjoyed everything. I am going to send you over to some cinematic shots of what we built here today, and I will see you in the next one. Have a good one. Peace.